He taught me how to drive, which took 3 years because I was very scared, and it was a long time. I still can't parallel park. He unfortunately passed before then, not related to my driving skills, but it meant a lot because when I was younger, he said, you will only ever be worth as much as you give back to others. And if you've been gifted with something special and you don't use that to make sure that everyone else is coming up with you, then it's a waste. So that's actually why I work with students. That's what inspired me to do all of my work and to protect. Another thing is that he was closeted for all of his life because he worked with young students, and he was afraid that anybody, if they knew who he really was, that they would reject him. And they'd say, you cannot come near my kid, go away. So the city could post newspaper articles about him, doing a great job. They could honor him at different events around El Paso, but he never felt comfortable enough to live a life where he could have a partner, where he could feel safe. And that's another reason why I do my job. That's the reason I'm currently the chair of Safe Space on campus, because I want to make sure that I can build a better world for people like him, and so that nobody would ever be hurt like him and have who they really are revealed in death, and they can live that beautiful life. So that's my story. If anybody would like to get up and share, please raise your hand. I know it's a little bit scary, but once you get up here, it's kind of refreshing. Anyone? Dr. Sanchez.
For me, and I think for a lot of other people, potentially on campus, around the city, in Texas, maybe even U.S., Dia de los Muertos holds a specific resonance, and it's because of the community loss that we had in August in El Paso, in your hometown, in which 22 people were victims of a violent attack that was motivated through the perpetrator's own words, because of hatred towards what he called the Hispanic community. And for me, it's important that we remember that, that we don't forget that that kind of hate exists, and that it's motivated by fear, and ignorance of the beauty and the importance of the Latinx community. Of which we're so representative here at Texas A&M San Antonio. I mean, it's a gorgeous community of intelligence and strength, creativity. I just can't say enough about you all as students, and I'm so proud to be here. I remember on Dia de los Muertos, my loved ones that have passed away. In particular, I remember my tia, Adela Sanchez, who lived and died on the south side of San Antonio on Linares Street. She taught me how to cook, how to make tortillas, and unfortunately, she never shared with me her mole recipe. And so what I have started to do at Thanksgiving, Indigenous peoples, is to go back to Indigenous ways of cooking based on some inspiration for decolonizing my diet. I don't know if you all have heard about this movement. So I basically look up recipes, mole recipes from like around Mexico, and then I to Maitia as if she's there. And I allow her to sort of like inspire me as I make the moles. So this will be my third year of making it for November 28th. Is that when it is this year? So that I can honor my indigenous heritage, even though I've been so separated from it that I don't have it documented. I'm still trying to reclaim it, which is what Dia de los Muertos means to me. So I love you, Dia. Thank you for being here with me. Yeah, that's it.